So I've had anxiety issues for at least a little over like 6-7 years now. But before, as a younger adult or young man, I didn't realize that it was anxiety that was actually going on in my head. I thought I was just being pretty much crazy and just feeling this type of sensation that anybody who has experienced anxiety would know. And when I was younger, I didn't really know how to control it. I just knew that it was there. And I noticed every time I'd get anxiety, all right, this is going to sound fucking weird. Every time I got anxiety, I always needed to take a shit for some reason. I don't know what it is. There's something that correlates with the mind and the body. And as soon as you get anxiety, you'll feel that like it's just like one thing that's like, all right, you need, like, as soon as that shit starts messing with my stomach, I'm like, damn, I need to go, boy. Like,
move, bitch.
And every time this would happen, I was like, damn, you know, it was only when I was feeling this type of way. And it wasn't until recently that I figured out how to actually control this anxiety and overcome these emotions that I was feeling. And it took a lot of time, I would say, you know, from that time frame of at least like 6-7 years ago. Because I remember being in like middle school and in high school and feeling this. But obviously it didn't affect me that bad because, I don't know, I wasn't too much into my head, you know. I would overthink here and there and kind of make myself get anxious. But it wasn't as bad as it was as I continued to get older. But now, as an adult, it got fairly easy to control, you know, this feeling or the sensation of anxiety and being anxious and pretty much stressing out about this. And I'm going to be teaching you guys how you guys can do that as well, because I know you guys may be young and may be experiencing this as well. And it's hard to control. So I'm going to give you guys some tips on how I was able to control it and overcome it. So first things first, in order to understand anxiety, you need to realize that there are different forms of it. There is separation anxiety, social anxiety. I'm more than sure there's more. I just can't think of the other ones. Those are the only two that I can say that I've related to. And I wouldn't want to give my opinion on the other ones because I haven't really experienced them. And I know when it comes to like mental health and shit like that, people don't take that shit lightly. They get all pissed off. And I don't want to be giving any advice on something that I don't have a good opinion on. So basically, when it came to separation anxiety, one thing that helped me was to continue to stay focused on whatever I was prioritizing, whatever I was working on. One of the things being was my YouTube channel. So I was continuing to just make videos when I'd go to work, just focus on work. It depends, because there's a lot of different separation anxieties. I know a lot of people suffer it sometimes with your parents or somebody passes away, or let's say an animal dies or something like that. The main thing that I noticed that helped was keeping your mind busy at all times, trying to distract yourself as much as possible. Sit down and meditate and think about why you are feeling this anxiety for at least a good 5 minutes. Come to terms on how you can fix it. And then after that, distract yourself 100%. So you already know, you don't have to be overthinking it again and again and again and again. Because I know usually with one thing with anxiety is like these thoughts, they continue to roll through your head and it's almost like they're on replay. And the only way to overcome that is to occupy yourself as much as possible. Now, this may be difficult for some people, but try to find a hobby or exercise. Go to the gym. Do whatever you possibly can to keep yourself moving and motivated. That's probably going to be your best bet of helping yourself and overcoming that feeling in your mind and in your body. The next one is social anxiety. So before, I used to get social anxiety because, honestly, I was smoking a lot of weed. This is not an invitation or not a influence on any of you guys, especially if you guys are younger, to try the use of marijuana. I was an adult when I was doing this. I still am an adult. And this was something that I noticed while I was using it. It made me develop social anxiety because before I was smoking, I did not have any social anxiety. It didn't bother me at all. I wasn't ever fazed by people looking at me or people that I didn't know, a bunch of people that I didn't know around me. None of that ever bothered me because I was able to, I mean, I didn't think about it, you know. I didn't overthink it. I was just there in the moment, just going to get groceries or going to buy shoes. Like, that's all I was going to do, you know. And usually whenever people go out and they have social anxiety, it's because they're afraid they're going to be judged or people are just pretty much looking at them. Obviously, if you're not under the influence of certain things, that will have an effect on you. Like I said, this only came on to me whenever I was under the influence of marijuana. When I wasn't, I was usually fine. But with the use of it, even sometimes when I was sober, I guess just because it affects your brain chemistry, you know, obviously this does have some type of chemical effect on your brain and your body. It would affect me when I was sober as well, because when I was sober, I'd be overthinking and just be in my head thinking that everybody's watching me, everybody's looking at me, or people are judging me, even though I'm not I think I'm a decent looking dude, you know. I'm not I dress okay, and there would be no reason for people to be looking at me or judging me, but still, you know, you just get inside your head, and that is the whole basis of why I was getting social anxiety. The reasons for you could be different, but the things that I noticed to help was listening to music. Every time I'd go out or go grocery shopping or something, I'd always pop headphones in and just ignore the world around me. I would continue to just listen to whatever I was listening to, whether it be a podcast or music, and I would just get so sucked up in the music and the podcast, you know, focusing on it, that I wouldn't pay any attention to the world around me, and I was pretty much unbothered, you know. I didn't think about the people around me. I was just trying to go in and go out, and that's it. And over time, as I continued to do this, it helped out a lot, and eventually I was like, okay, there's really no reason for me to listen to music anymore. I feel okay enough to walk into a store and not feel anxious, and that was pretty much after a while of doing it, I didn't need the music anymore to go into the store. It eventually became so easy that I was able to just go in there like normal before, get what I needed to get, and get out and not feel any anxiety or any stress because of the people around me. Now, you guys may be experiencing different anxiety, but I guess for the whole general anxiety, one thing that I can say is try not to be inside your head so much. And I know that's kind of difficult to say, because I feel like, I don't know, a lot of people are overthinkers, myself included, and it's difficult to not be so much inside your head and just overthinking everything and over-evaluating everything. And it's hard. It definitely is really hard. But try to focus your attention on something else. Try to think about something else while you're in this state of anxiety. Force your brain to become so sucked up with other thoughts and other problems that you may be dealing with that you're trying to solve, that you don't feel the need to think about the world around you or feel anxious about anything else. But I hope you guys did enjoy. If you guys would like to see more videos like these, please let me know down in the comment section below. If you guys are new to the channel and would like to see more videos like these on your homepage, please feel free to subscribe. If you guys could help me out with a like, I would appreciate that as well. Thank you guys for watching. I've been Handsome Merc, and we'll see you guys later.